Hi, I'm Glenn from Agile Equipment Hire, and today we're going to talk about air filtration. Indoor air quality can go unnoticed much of the time, but it affects us more often than we know. To improve air quality, knowing the formula and the right gear makes it a whole lot easier. During remediation work, construction, or after a building damage like mold, flooding, or a fire, or during demolition works, it's especially important to ensure that air is free from floating dangers. A popular option is the HEPA air scrubber. These pull air through a series of filters that removes 99.97% of airborne particles, 0.3 microns or larger. There are also extra filter options available for issues like odors or for even finer particle filtration. After air is pulled through the filter, you can either vent it out of the affected space to create negative pressure, or leave it to blow back into the room, which would leave it at neutral pressure. Additionally, after a space is verified as clean, you can always place the area under positive pressure by having the unit outside the area and venting back in the clean air. This will help stop any unfiltered air from entering back into the area. For a small room, you may only need one air scrubber, but for larger spaces, you'll probably need more. One of our recent clients needed over 130 of them on their construction site. Admittedly, this is a bit of an extreme case. So how many HEPA units do you actually need? Well, to answer that, you need to know two things. How big is the project area? Yes, this involves a little maths. And what is the source and nature of the contamination? Answering these will tell us how much air needs to be filtered and how often, and what units you need to use. For proper filtration, the air has to be cycled through several times per hour, depending on what you need to filter out. The IICRC S520 standard for mold remediation advises for small demolition works, or after a small clean water damage, 1 to 2 air changes per hour should suffice. However, for mold, you'll need a minimum of 4 air changes an hour under negative pressure. Other contaminants like silica dust, VOCs, or asbestos may have their own standards to follow, so be sure to consult the relevant standards before undertaking any work. Okay, now onto the maths. So this is our equation here. First, you need to figure out the amount of air in the room. And you can do that by getting the total area of the room, the cubic area. So that's a length times width times height in meters. And because most air filter units are described in CFM, it means we'll need to convert to imperial units, to cubic feet. So we multiply that by 35.31. And that'll give us the amount of cubic feet of air in the room. And then we times by the amount of air changes that we need per hour. And then we divide by 60 to get it from cubic feet per hour to cubic feet per minute. And then what that'll give us is the CFM needed. So say if we have a room that is 5 meters long and 7 meters wide and is 2.7 meters high. And because we're gonna say it's a mold job, so that means it would need at least 4 air changes per hour. So if I get my calculator out and just calculate this, 5 times 7 times 2.7, which gives us 94.5 cubic meters. And we just times that by 35.31 to get it to cubic feet. And then we multiply that by 4 air changes per hour. We get a total of 13,347 cubic feet of air that we need to cycle through per hour. So we just divide that by 60 and we will get cubic feet per minute of air that we need to cycle through. So I'm gonna divide this number by 60 and that comes to 222.45 CFM. If you're looking to use, say, one of our standard units, the 500 CFM HEPA unit, you can see that 500 is more than enough to cover 222 CFM. So you would only need one unit. Say if you had a much larger room, say if you needed to move 1700 cubic feet per minute, and you wanted to use one of our 500 CFM units, you can just divide that 1700 by 500. Which would equal
3.4.
Because you can't have 0.4 of a unit, obviously, you would just round up and you would have 4 units. So you would need 4 units to get 1700 cubic feet per minute. That being said, if you have multiple rooms in this area, air between these rooms might be restricted. So you will need, you might need at least one unit per room. And you also need to take into account the amount of contents in the room. Say if you had lots of bookshelves and things like that, that might also restrict airflow. So that's just something else to think about. So now back to the warehouse.
Here at Agile Equipment Hire, we have a diverse variety of HEPA filtration units available. These vary in CFM from small units up to large 2000 CFM units. If you require HEPA filtration, call us on 1300 092 647 or visit our website at agileequipmenthire.com.au. Have a great day.